Hello and welcome to Umbraco Learning Base. Jonathan here. In this video, I'm going to show you where you can find the log files generated in the Umbraco CMS so you can use them to debug your Umbraco site if it has any issues. The underlying framework that we use for logging in Umbraco is Serilogs. Out of the box, we write a JSON log file that contains a more rich log files that allows us to perform searches and correlations on log patterns a lot easier. Serilog allows us to do a structured logging or write log messages using the message template format. This allows us to have a more detailed log message rather than the traditional text message in a long text file. Here we have an example for how the log file looks like in the Umbraco CMS. And as you can see, we get a lot of information from the log file in a very readable way. Let's have a quick look at the Serilog settings that you can edit in the appsettings.json file in your Umbraco project. Okay, as you can see, I have my project open up here, and let's go over and open up our appsettings.json file. As you can see, the Serilog settings are at the top of the JSON file, and it is included by default when creating a new Umbraco project. Here you can enable a couple of different settings. For example, you can specify the minimum log level, or you can change the log level for specific namespaces, just to name a few. I'm not going to go into great details in this video. However, I am going to link the documentation down below in the description. Great. Let's now have a look at the built-in log viewer that comes with the Umbraco CMS out of the box. Okay, to find the log viewer, go to the settings tab up here, and over here at the left, we can see that we have the log viewer. Awesome. Here in the log viewer, first of all, we can filter the time period from when we want to see which log files have been generated. So we can choose the dates down here and the range over here, and then we can see the number of errors that we have during this date. We see the log level, and then we can see the log types over here as well, while also filtering through them to see how many there is compared to one of the others. So if we click around here, as you can see in this small diagram. Awesome. Then we have the saved searches and common log messages. With the saved searches, we can search our log files. And with the common log messages, we can see the most common log messages that has been generated in our logs. Great. Let's now click on the number of errors over here. And as you can see all the errors and the search query that is used to find the errors. We can also filter and the log levels over here. And over here, we can see the saved searches in our log viewer as well, as we can see up here. Awesome. Now let's try and click on one of the errors and have a look at it. As you can see, we can see the error message over here. And down below, we get some more information. For example, we get the timestamp, message template, event ID, the source context, the request ID, request path, process ID, process name, thread ID, application ID, machine name, and the log for net level as well, which can help you debug your issues on your Umbraco site. Great. Now let's have a look at where you can find the log files outside of the log viewer in your Umbraco installation. Okay, let's get back to my project here and close it down. Once it closed down, let's go down and open up my folder down here. As you can see, I have my Umbraco project files over here. Let's open up the Umbraco folder down here. And as you can see in here, we have the logs folder. As you can see, I have two log files that has been generated on this project. Let's open one of them up in a Visual Studio. Great. As you can see, it's now opened up in Visual Studio and there's a lot of information. There's a lot of information and it's also quite hard to read it at all. To make it easier, let's use a software called Compact Log Viewer created by my good colleague Warren. So let's open it up here, as you can see, and let's go down to our files down here, and let's take one of the log files and drag it in to the log viewer over here. Awesome. As you can see, it gives us a nice overview of our log file. Up here, we can search our log file, and over here, we can see the number of errors, and down here, we can see the log level with this diagram, as well as the number of different log messages as well. Over here, we can see the log messages. We have some error messages and information messages. And down here, we can also see the message templates and the number of them as well. Great. Let's now click on the errors. As we can see, it then filters out everything else and only our errors. If we click on the errors, again, we can see the error message that we have in this log file. And if we scroll down, just like in the log viewer in the CMS, we also get a lot of information that will help us to debug the issue that we are having. Awesome. So with the compact log viewer, you can get a nice overview of your log files, which then can help you debug any issues that you might encounter as well. I'll make sure to add the link in the description down below to where you can download the compact log viewer. Okay, so in this video, we have seen how you can view your log files in the Umbraco CMS using the built-in log viewer, as well as where you can find the log files and get an overview of the content of the log file by using the compact log viewer. This is all that I have for you this time. My name is Jonathan, and I'll see you in the next one. Jonathan out.